Me at the Financial Spotlight. I'm Chantrell, here to give you financial tips and tricks. So obviously you are here because you are looking for credit cards that you can sign up for that will approve you if you have bad credit, poor credit, or even if you have no credit. Also, if you're trying to build your credit back up, I have three great credit cards that will help you. And I also have a tidbit of information that I'm going to share with you at the end of this video. So please continue to listen to or watch this video until the end so that you can get that great information. So let's talk about what a FICO score is. So normally when you look at your credit score, you know that your credit score deems whether you can buy a home, you can get a credit card, you can buy a car, etc. And so what they deem the poor credit score or bad credit score is usually from about 300 to 579. Also, fair credit score, and that's what most Americans fall in. About 61% of Americans fall in the fair credit score area, and that is from 580 to 669. And then the good credit score, excellent credit score, theirs is from 670 to 850. Now, if you fall in the poor or bad credit score area, or even in the average or fair credit score area, then you would want to take time to get these credit cards to build up your credit. The first one that I'm going to suggest to you is called Open Sky. Open Sky is a secured credit card. Now, what I mean by secured is that you would give them a deposit. They would keep that deposit for a year and then return it to you later on, kind of like a savings. It is also insured by the FDIC like a savings. And this securement or this secured deposit will be your credit limit on your credit card. The downfall to Open Sky is that they have an annual fee of $35. The positive thing about Open Sky is that they do not run your credit. So you are basically guaranteed to be approved for Open Sky Visa credit card. Also, they report to the three credit bureaus, Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion. So that'll be beneficial for you in the long run. The second card is the Credit One Bank Visa card. Now, with Credit One, I would not suggest keeping that card past 3 years because basically you're using it to build up your credit. They also give you a 1% cash back on every purchase that you make. They have a Visa, and their annual fee can range from $0 to $99 that first initial time, and then $99 thereafter. So like I said, you don't want to keep the Credit One Visa bank card too long, but you can use it to build up your credit. Also, they do not require a secured deposit. So your range of your credit limit usually ranges from around 300 to 500, and then you can each year request that they increase your credit limit. The final credit card that I would suggest is with Capital One. Now, with Capital One, they have many different credit cards. They have a secured credit card, they have one for students, they have a platinum, and they have one that has a cash back option as well. But the one that is the best to me is the Capital One Platinum card. It is not secured. They do not charge an annual fee. So that's why I think that's the best one. They also report to all of the credit bureaus, just like Credit One too. All three of these cards report to all of the credit bureaus for you, so that while you have these credit cards, you are building up your credit score. I hope this information has helped you thus far. Go ahead and click like if you like what I'm providing for you, and share this information with your friends and family. But wait a minute, don't go anywhere because I have a little bit more of information for you. Now, if you're trying to build up your credit and you want to do it yourself, you don't want to go to a credit counselor or to a credit repair company, I have a DIY credit repair kit available for you. The link is in the description box. And with this kit, I have included letters that you can write or actually print out and send to all three of the credit bureaus to dispute anything that's on your credit report. I have included a checklist of all of the questions that you should ask yourself as you're going through your credit report to make sure that the information on your credit report is correct. And I have also given you step-by-step instructions on what you need to do every step of the way as you go on your road trying to clean your credit up. This is a great kit, and I would love to have you go ahead and get it for yourself today so that you can get your credit on the right road. Now, my final tidbit of information is for those of you that have friends and or family who have a wonderful high credit score. If you can contact one of them and ask them if they can put you on their credit card as a authorized signer, then you can build your credit score up very quickly, at least 100 points within a couple of months if they are willing to do that. Now, you need to make sure that this person has excellent credit and that they pay their bills on time, because you definitely don't want to make your credit score worse because you have gotten yourself on someone's account as a signer and then your credit score goes down because they're not paying their bills on time. But if you do have someone that you can trust and that will trust you enough to put you on their credit card, you can let them know, hey, I'm not going to use your credit card at all. I just want to be an authorized signer so that I can build my credit up and I can get to the place where I can purchase a home with less interest and also purchase a car with less interest rate. So those are the benefits of increasing your credit score. I hope this information helped you. Like I said before, please like this message. Also, share it with your friends and family. And please go ahead and subscribe to the channel so that you can be a part of the Financial Spotlight family. And hit the notification bell so that you know exactly when I post every week financial tips and tricks for you so that you can grow your money. Thanks for joining me. Have a great one.